I want to tell you something else that our generosity as a church has been able to do. A few years back, I had laid on my heart that we were going to be for something, not just against something. We're not for abortion. We are against abortion, but we wanted to be for something as well. So we're for adoption. And so we made a big step as a church. I stood up on this very stage and I said, guys, gals, today we're going to raise money to be able to help fund adoptions. And we were so excited about that. And that was like a little pebble that got rolling into this huge snowball. And I want you to celebrate with me where we are right now. So I want to bring out two ladies, two moms that are amazing, amazing ladies. One of them is my wife, Kelly Mott, that I'm going to bring out here with us. Amazing mom. Mom, amazing wife. And then the other is Tony Steer, an amazing mom as well. Tony is the head of our Legacy 685 that comes from Psalm 68:5, that God is a father to the fatherless. And she's in charge of our adoption ministry. And I wanted you to be here, Tony. We've been talking for a long time. I've been saying, tell me when. And now I wanted you to be here with me because here's where we are. And church, we're going to celebrate. We've hit a marker, a big time marker. That little pebble kept rolling. We have mobilized through our giving and matching funds. We have mobilized over $2 million for adoption. Absolutely incredible. You should be cheering right now at your house, cheering, being able to go along. It's going to get even better. We have helped adoption with 19 countries, from kids from 19 countries. And here's the thing. You ready, Tony? I know you're excited. You ready to go?
I'm ready.
Okay, good, because this is big time. You've done this and all those around you, but you've been the tip of the spear on this. Church, are you ready? First time ever announced here on Mother's Day. I want you to know this. We have now hit the mark that we have been a part of funding 200 kids to be adopted. Yes and amen. All right, come on. I hope there's little like hearts flying up Facebook right now. I hope it's incredible what you're seeing. Here's what I want you to do as you're cheering, as you're liking, as you're loving, as you're commenting down below. Can you believe it? 200 kids, wow, 200 families, 200 lives. We got to be a part of that through our generosity. Absolutely incredible. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you a slideshow that you're going to see some of these faces. And I want you to lock in to those kids and those families and know that you are a part of it through our church. And then we're going to sit down right here and we're going to ask Tony a couple questions so that we can hear her heart and we can hear what God's done through this. So let's watch this slideshow together and let it touch your heart.
Stories, but they all sound too good to be true. You've heard about a place called home, but there doesn't seem to be one for you. So one more night you cry yourself to sleep. Counting down the days until like the rain that falls into the sea. In a moment, what has been is lost in what will be. When love takes you in.
Oh man, seeing those faces, seeing those kids, it's just amazing. And church, we're a part of that. Is that incredible to think about on this Mother's Day? And as we sit here with Kelly and with Tony, Tony, tell us, I mean, how did your heart get moving in this adoptive way and to be an adoptive parent yourself?
Well, thank you for having me here. And yes, I was young and gave the Lord one small yes. I said yes to a short-term mission trip to Botswana, Africa, and spent a month in the desert and interacted with so many children who had no caregiver, who were being taken in by neighbors and strangers, even due to the HIV/AIDS crisis. And the Lord pricked my heart and began inviting me to be a part of their stories. And that led me to become a full-time missionary in Guatemala City, Guatemala, at a large orphanage. And I went as a teacher and ended up house parenting, as so often happens in those situations. You wear lots of hats. And our family grew by one unexpectedly on June 18th, 2001, when God brought us a tiny 4-pound baby. And he extended our hearts in ways that we did not know needed to be extended. And as I spent time with the Lord and time caring for this little one, the Lord revealed that that was something permanent. He was inviting me to be a part of this baby's story for life.
Wow. And now, how old is that 4-pound baby of yours?
Well, he's 19 and just finished his freshman year. So
19. That is so 19. Amazing. Yeah. And so great. And he's part of our church. I just love seeing him around. He's such a great, great guy. And so, man, so you're not only an adoptive parent, you're a single parent as well. Mm-hmm. And so this Mother's Day is so special. And to be able to have you and to celebrate 200 kids that we've been able to help fund with that, which is great. That's we've got some just questions we want to ask you, and then we'll wrap up our time in just a couple moments. But Kelly, would you ask Tony a question or two?
Sure, yes. It's such a joy to be with you, and truly remarkable what God has done. Amazing to just hear your story and God's story just through your life. So just as you reflect on 200-plus adoption assistance awards given to families across the world through the generosity of our church. What are some of your thoughts on that?
Well, when I think about what God has done, there's the prophet reminds us that we should not despise small beginnings. And as Pastor Greg talked about, we started small with the big idea and some small funds that God has used immensely across the world. And so I think about the fact that there really is no asking without it first and foremost being about the faithfulness of God. And there isn't any giving without it first being first and foremost about the faithfulness of God. And there's no receiving without it being first and foremost about the faithfulness of God. And so I think about how we as a church body have played active roles in every part of this process for 200 children. And so those families who have heard God saying to their hearts, adoption is what I'm asking you to do. I'm asking you to step into this child's story. Often they can look at the financial barriers and feel like it's impossible. And that's where we get to come alongside. And in the humility that it takes to expose your family, for those who have been through the adoption journey, you know it is just very exposing. Every closet is looked in, every document is scoured. And so to expose those financial needs can be hard. But it gives God a chance to put his faithfulness on display. And in the giving and the receiving, again, we get to move toward God in his faithfulness.
Ah, that's incredible. Well, he is so faithful and so strong. And it's just, you know, you see just like our verse, Psalm 68:5, that he is a father to the fatherless. And, you know, we'd see in James, you know, this is pure and undefiled religion, that we would love the orphan and the widow. And so it's just a great thing. You know, you've been on this journey and leading this journey, and we're so grateful. with many other families in our church and many other folks, and we are so grateful for them as well.
Yes.
You know, I know a bunch of you really well, and thanks for all that you've done as well. What have been some surprises that you've seen along the way with this journey?
Well, I think specifically when we think about the Adoption Assistance Fund, it would be really easy to look at all of the needs coming in and to become anxietized about, will there be enough? It would be really easy to try and control it or micromanage it, or even to try and grow it. And if there's anything that we have learned as a team over the last 12 years, it is that God is faithful and we can't outgive him. There's just no way to outgive him. I'll never forget Steve Klein coming down after talking with Pastor Greg and saying, okay, I think we're going to up our grants. And I said, what do you mean by that? And he said, let's give it away in big clumps. Let's give away big grants. And I thought, wow, okay, well, we've got lots of needs. I hope it lasts. And so we did. We started giving it away and double, triple what we had originally been doing. And one of the most beautiful things that our staff and our team get to see is we will literally watch a petition come in, we'll look at the grant size, we'll vote, pray on the grant size, and before we send that grant off, the Lord sends the funds right back, if not in excess, to the fund. You can't outgive God. He is so generous, and he is the father to the fatherless, and he sets children and family. And so for him, these finances are not insurmountable. They're provided for at the yes.
They sure are. That's amazing. So good.
Wow. Just amazing. God has shown himself to you and revealed himself in such a powerful way. And just what an amazing experience that must be. So what would you like us to know? What do you want us to know as we end this time, just about Legacy 685? Yeah. What do you want us to know?
Well, adoption is not just about a family wrapping around a child. It's about the Big C Church wrapping around a family who chooses to wrap their lives around a child. This is what this ministry is about, and this is what you've been a part of. You have truly made a difference in the life of 200-plus children and over 160 families. It's transformational for these children, and so I want us as a church, I want you as a church to know that you have truly made a difference in wrapping around families as they wrap around children. I also want you to know that it doesn't end with the fund. That's our on-ramp, and so as a church, we get to connect families with funds, yes, we get to connect families with families in gatherings and support groups. We get to equip them for the unique journey. And one of the things that we love most is that we get to come around them. As Aaron and Ur did for Moses in Exodus 17, we get to hold their arms up throughout the healing and connection journey as these families learn together what it means to be a forever family. And so I want to thank you for choosing to not just fund, but to wrap around families as they wrap around children.
So good. Well, I'm blown away by all we do with our classes, drawing people in. We've got a program, how we lead people forth. And, you know, when I've seen all of that, I'm just always blown away. And glory to God
yes.
on what he has done and the faithfulness of God and the ways the Lord has used this ministry. Mm-hmm. It's incredible to think about. You know, we just had something on our heart years ago. And we're like, what if we do this? And we took up a special offering that day and it came in and we gave that seed. And then we just started giving it away over and over and over. And I tell you, a generous church is an impactful church. And to be able to see how God has done that is so great. And I love, you know, on this Mother's Day, we've got a robust single parent ministry. We've got a robust special needs ministry. We've got a robust adoption ministry. We've got robust at every campus of children and youth and students. I mean, you know, it's so great. But I love this one in particular because we have been adopted by Christ.
Yes.
We're all adopted children in Jesus. And so it's so great. So thank you for all that you've done. Thank you, church, for all your giving. And on this Mother's Day, we just wanted to celebrate this. 200 kids. I can't believe it. It's so amazing to see just an idea, a seed from the Lord, blossom into something really great.
Hey, thanks for watching. To find out more about Houston's First, you can subscribe to our channel or you can go to houstonsfirst.org.